Sarah Bear Sinnott. I'm the president of Oldways. We're a nonprofit food and nutrition organization based in Boston with a mission to guide people to better health through heritage. We like to say, let the old ways be your guide to good health and well-being. We're about traditional foods, like the Mediterranean diet. But we also talk about traditions and apply them to modern life. We're always grounded in science, helping consumers, dietitians, doctors. Food is an important part of who we are for good health, lifestyle, good for preserving traditions and history, and also good for the earth, sustainability. We also organize culinary tours all over the Mediterranean. We're here in Pantelleria, the volcanic island between Tunisia and Sicily. It's only 14 kilometers long and 9 kilometers wide, filled with winding roads. There's no real straight path, but the path is pleasure, winding up the mountains or down the hills and into the valley with stone walls on either side of the road. Very tight, such beautiful scenery as we drive alongside the Mediterranean Sea. Really, really beautiful. And we at Oldways have brought a group of culinary experts to enjoy a week of exploration to learn the secrets of Pantelleria. The group was lucky enough to stay at the Murcia Hotel, which is right on the ocean. Very peaceful.
I go back with these guys 20 years. It's really a great organization that has probably done more for the education of journalists than any other organization I know in the U.S. Oldways was founded by a dear friend of mine who passed away a couple years ago. His name was Dunn Gifford, a once-in-a-lifetime guy.
Dunn was a visionary, and we are carrying his mission forward.
I met Sarah and Dunn, the founder, on an Oldways trip on the island of Greece. It was an experience unlike I've ever had before in the business. It brought together scientists and journalists and producers of incredible products and people involved in the commercial side. And now healthy eating is really the most important public health issue. So much of how we relate to each other has become intangible in how we communicate, where food and the sharing of ideas is almost the last vestige of communicating.
It's interesting for me to watch the way Oldways has evolved from some very specific interests in gastronomy into something that is embracing ever new questions of health, good eating, and of traditional food cultures, and also an increased interest in sustainable agriculture as the basis for healthy eating. And certainly that is thanks to Sarah. Everything they undertake, it turns out to be, I think, a magnificent experience.
One of the great secrets of Pantelleria, capers. We had an entire day of starting in the caper fields. They pick the caper before the flower blooms. They sort the capers by size.
The caper is an unopened flower bud, and they pick it before the flower opens. If you don't pick the caper, it becomes a flower. Later on, the flower falls off and you get the fruit of the plant, the caper berry.
We are at the caperificio, where they're processing the capers.
Capers from Pantelleria. This is our laboratory. We are here from 2004. Here we produce pesto, sauces, and pate, all with capers and with other raw material from the island.
We continued on with a lunch. We ate capers from the beginning to end.
It's in a town called Scauri. It's called La Nicchia. We first had a little assortment of goodies that had capers in various forms and sauces and sun-dried tomatoes and some delicious cheese called tuma, T-U-M-M-A, pasta. They call it casarecci, with sauce in which the flavor of caper was really prominent. Lots of things on top like breadcrumbs and toasted almonds, and it really had a wonderful texture to it.
Such fresh swordfish with the capers on it. Pantelleria is all about wind. There's always wind on Pantelleria. The plants have adapted to the landscape so that the olive trees are not tall like you would expect in other parts of the Mediterranean. They're low because they've learned to protect themselves from the wind and because there's less water here, but they're spectacularly beautiful. The secrets of Pantelleria is in large part due to the friendship between Oldways and Fausto Lucchetti. Fausto is a longtime resident of Pantelleria.
Pantelleria is a crossroad of many civilizations, architectural aspects, archaeological aspects, historic aspects, religions also, Muslims, Jewish, and Christians, an example of peaceful coexistence, relaxed, no stress, the most evident interpretation of Mediterranean style life.
At the Abraxas Winery, we had the group from Trapani giving a demonstration about pesto trapanese, a wonderful way to enjoy pasta.
The first thing you need to know is that this is the poor people's pasta. It's a cold sauce, not hot, and it's made of the pizzutello tomatoes from Pacheco, basil,
basilic,
garlic from Nubia, salt in the mortar,
muttaro,
extra virgin olive oil. It's good for your skin. Very simple, but it's very tasty. Can you smell the aroma from there?
Yes! Yeah.
Chop the almonds and then just put fresh on top of it.
Voila! Tiffany.
Now, we had one of the historians of the island, Giuseppe Dietti, take the group to what's called the Sesi, a funeral burying ground very close to where we were staying at the Murcia.
Sese singolare, Sesi plurale.
Sese singular, Sesi.
Sesi.
And I think the group enjoyed this Sesi very much.
Sese!
We had an introduction with the architect, Gabriella, who has been the driving force for the rebirth of the Domuso in the last 20 years. And talked about the tradition of the Domuso and the rural landscape.
Domuso, there must be thousands of them all over the island. They're old stone structures of Arabic origin, usually with a white dome on top.
Behind me is Cala Levante and the Ark of the Elephant on the northwest coast of Pantelleria. The views are incredible. And it's part of the Mediterranean lifestyle, enjoying nature and taking time to smell the roses. We had the olive oil tasting at the Domuso of Fausto and Mara Lucchetti. He actually has two Domusos, and we had the olive oil tasting at what he calls his yellow Domuso, El Saguaro. Fausto is the longtime executive director of the International Olive Oil Council, very responsible for olive oil being on the tables of restaurants, grocery store shelves, and kitchens of consumers across the U.S.
There's a great little restaurant, Le Cale. It's in a little town called Cala Tramontana. Started off with potatoes, eggplant, tomatoes, peppers, olive oil. Really good. The main course, we had pasta, which were big, fat pasta, what they call in Naples, baccheri. Beautifully tossed in a tomato and shellfish sauce with a lot of little shrimp around and stuff like that. We had some great pecorino cheese with chili peppers in it, very Southern Italian. And then we had cannoli.
We focused on the Mediterranean diet with three amazing women. First, Antonia Trikopoulou, as the mother of the Mediterranean diet. She has been focusing on the science, and it's her passion. She was followed by Kathy McManus. Kathy talked about how to embrace this on a practical level, how to take the Mediterranean diet and put it into practice every day. Lithia Dominguez hit on a topic that is going to be so important, which is successful aging and how the Mediterranean diet really can be a successful way to age. We went up into the mountains. Some of the group went in to enjoy the natural sauna at Bagnasciutto. Felt wonderful. Very, very hot.
Super hot. Thick fog penetrates your lungs. It's just natural. It just hangs in the air.
The Lago di Venere, a lake inside the volcano, and there's special mud. So we had a number of the groups swimming in the Lake of Venus, coming out saying that their skin has never been softer. A wonderful restaurant, Pantelleria Dream. Excellent food, a seafood couscous demonstration by a home cook, Rosalba Salerno, who also has just opened a restaurant in Pantelleria. 30 minutes of hard labor, but well worth it.
I'm at a restaurant right now called La Vela, right on the water, about 20 minutes south of the town of Pantelleria. We had penne, pancakes made out of chickpeas, parmigiana. The eggplant is not fried. Spaghetti with pesto pantesca, spaghetti made with sea urchin, con ricci, spaghetti with zucchini and ricotta salata, fritto. Local calamari deep fried.
Sito de Pantelleria is one of the things that Pantelleria is famous for, along with capers. It's the wine made from the dried grapes, Zibibbo grapes. They make the wine very sweet, and it's a perfect way to end a meal. We also went to a fabulous winery yesterday, Basile, near Monastero, up on the hill above Scauri. We had a lunch made by the mother of the current owner. Wonderful white wine, ending the meal with a Basile. pasito de Pantelleria.
Pasito!
Pantelleria in our when you're in Italy. Your feet are on the ground and you live hour by the hour and you see, you feel. I'm very, very happy to be here.
So what Sarah and Oldways have really done is take time out of our busy digital lives to live the old ways for a little while.
Thank you for sharing the secrets of beautiful Pantelleria. Grazie mille, arrivederci from Oldways.